Hello everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how you can install one more important software, that is PyCharm, with the activation code. This software is uploaded in our official Telegram channel, that is EdCorner Official. So you can download this software by joining our Telegram channel, and you just click this link. As soon as you click the link, it will go to our Google Drive. Here you can download the software. So if you don't have a Telegram channel, I'm sharing my email ID in the description so that you can mail me and I can share this download link. Also, Telegram channel link is shared in the description. So before continuing, I request you people to please subscribe to our channel so that you will not miss any latest software with its activation key or crack or license keys, and everything I'll be uploading in this Telegram channel, so the corner official. The link will be given in the description. Okay, so once you have downloaded the software, so go to that folder, right click and unzip that folder. Okay, so once it is unzipped, open this folder. Here you have PyCharm Professional, double click on that. So click on yes, next. So just check your destination folder, click next. So create a desktop shortcut, then add bin folder to path, then next, then click install. So it will take bit time to install. Wait for it to install properly. So if you want to reboot, you can click reboot. So I will click I want to manually reboot later and click finish. So now it is successfully installed. Now to check this, go to your desktop and double click on PyCharm. So now you can see it is not activated. It's asking either activate the PyCharm or start a free trial. Since this video I'm giving you activation code, so I will explain you how you can activate this PyCharm, and these steps are just education purpose only. It is not entertained to activate like this. You have to buy the PyCharm with the official website. Okay, so now to continue this, to activate this PyCharm, so what you have to do is, first step, so in your downloaded folder you have net filter all, copy this and paste in your local disk C. Okay, so once it is done, go to downloaded folder again and click on net filter all and go to scripts. Here select whether you want to install for all user or install for current user. So I will click install for all users and click yes, then click OK and wait for pop up with indicating it's done. Okay, now it is showing it's done. Okay, so now we'll open our PyCharm. So follow my steps step by step, don't miss any steps. Next, go to activation code. Here we have to paste our activation code. Now for that, again go to downloaded folder, and here you have a text file PyCharm. Copy entire thing and paste here and click activate. You can see it is activated till 2025. Okay, so then click continue. Okay, Now you can see it is successfully activated. In this video, again I will show you how you can print Hello World program, Python Hello World program with this PyCharm. So now to create a project, click a new project. Here you can set a location. So I will select some location here. So in D I will select PyCharm and I'll click OK. Okay, so then I will click create. So it will create a virtual environment. Okay, so now to create a new Python file, on this PyCharm folder right click and new, and here you click Python file and name anything you want. I'll name say example dot py and click enter. Okay, now you have created a new file example.py. Here we'll print something, print hello, welcome to EduTech corner. Okay, so I will print, so this statement, hello, welcome to EduTech corner, and on top you have run. I will click run. So it will print hello, welcome to EduTech corner. If by default it selected main.py, so then here you have to go to edit configuration, and here you have to change the script path. So in my folder we have main.py and example.py. So if by default it is main.py, then select example.py and run the program. Okay, and one more thing, make sure that interpreter is selected. Now to run this PyCharm, you should install a Python, latest version of Python in your Windows machine. So then only this editor will run. So make sure that Python 3.9 or above or latest Python interpreter is installed. Now if you face any problem, mention in comment so that I can help you. And if you like this video, please press subscribe button and share this video to your friends. If you want to learn Python programming, mention in comment so that I will create a separate dedicated playlist for Python programming.